Raynaud's is a condition that results in decreased blood flow to your fingers and toes when you're exposed to cold, stress, or changes in relative temperature. It can cause symptoms of numbness or tingling to the affected areas and cause a color change in your fingers to white, blue, and then often a red discoloration that follows the episode. Patients can be affected who don't have another connective tissue disease, and typically that type of Raynaud's is called primary Raynaud's, and it mainly affects young women in their teens and 20s. Symptoms typically improve over time. Many patients often have full resolution of symptoms by the time they're in their 30s or 40s. However, there's a second type of Raynaud's called secondary Raynaud's that affects patients with connective tissue diseases such as scleroderma, lupus, rheumatoid arthritis, vasculitis, and others. This type of Raynaud's tends to be later in onset, usually after the age of 30. It also affects more women than men and can be associated with some more significant complications. For example, in primary Raynaud's, patients don't typically tend to have ulcers on the tips of their fingers or lose fingers as a consequence of their cold exposure. But in secondary Raynaud's, that can happen. So patients who have Raynaud's as a consequence of another disease have to be a little bit more careful. In both situations, the Raynaud's can be managed by staying warm, avoiding triggers such as stress and changes in relative temperature, and carrying around hot hands or the little packets that warm your fingers to keep handy when your fingers start to spasm. Sometimes running the hands under warm water can also be helpful in resolving the episode. Patients who have primary Raynaud's usually have normal blood studies, so they don't usually have antibodies or other abnormalities in their blood. But patients with secondary Raynaud's usually have some sort of abnormality, either on the blood tests, physical exam, or both. And this will usually tell the doctor that there's something else that's ongoing that should be investigated. When you have secondary Raynaud's, it can be important sometimes to take medication to help those symptoms. Not in everybody, if you're experiencing more symptoms, then that can be helpful. So for example, if you're experiencing ulcers on the tips of your finger or have little indentations at the tips of the fingers called digital pits, or if you have even more significant damage to the finger, then your doctor will probably want to put you on a medication called a calcium channel blocker, such as nifedipine, amlodipine, or fludipine. These medications can be helpful in dilating blood vessels to maximize the blood flow to the tips of the fingers and toes. There are other medications that can be helpful, such as phosphodiesterase inhibitors, meaning medications like Viagra or Cialis. Those also improve blood flow to the fingers and toes. And medications for pulmonary hypertension would also benefit the Raynaud's. Some patients have a challenge in the sense that their blood pressures run low, so dilating the blood vessels further can exacerbate the low blood pressure. But in such a situation, there are other options. We work closely with our plastic surgeons and hand specialists where they can inject Botox into the fingers, which can be helpful in some patients in dilating the blood vessels locally but not affecting systemic blood pressures. In addition, there are topical agents like topical nitroglycerin that can be helpful, medications such as selective serotonin receptor uptake inhibitors or SSRIs, which are also used to manage stress and mood, and those have been shown to be helpful in Raynaud's as well. And medications such as statins, which actually are known for their ability to control cholesterol, also may have a beneficial effect in patients with Raynaud's as well. If Raynaud's presents after the age of 30 or so, it's definitely something that you should talk about with your physician. Raynaud's will present with pallor of the fingers, meaning that the fingers will look like they've either been dipped in white ink or blue ink. It's not a mottled or speckled pattern of white or blue, and it's definitely not something that only affects the fingernails. But if you do have those signs of pallor or blue discoloration of the fingers after the age of 30, you should go and speak with your doctor, because it could be an early sign of something else that's going on in your body, such as another autoimmune disease, thyroid disease, etc.